Okay, welcome. Now let's start with root words. In the previous video, I said we will start off with the root words. What are these root words? Every word that we use has an origin, somewhere it originated. In English language, almost 26% of the words that we use are from Roman. Then around 24-26% of the words are French. Then we have Spanish, Latin. Then around 100 other languages, English language has words from. There are certain languages which you probably don't know that they exist, but English has languages from them. And you'll be surprised to know some of the words which you till date knew were English. Your belief will be shaken if I tell you that. Banana is a African word, Swahili's word. It's an African word, it's not an English word. Lychee that you eat, udhar Bihar mein Muzaffarpur and Pusa Dholi udhar bahut hota hai. So in there, that lychee is in fact a Chinese word. Tea, chai peete hai na, tea, that's a Chinese word. Right, there are a lot of words from Hindi which is there. There are a lot of words from Tamil, Telugu, Malayalam, Gujarati, yes, Koli, Kuli. The word Kuli comes from that word Koli, which is in Gujarati. So like this, there are many words. Even Odia, you have this juggernaut. That's a word that is in English language, juggernaut. That comes from the Odia word, that is Jagannath. So like this, if imagine there are so many words of only Indian origin, what about the rest of the world? So the English language, that is why it seems difficult to a learner, because most of the words that you have in the English language have been taken from different languages. Greek, Roman, Latin, Spanish. Greek words are less, but more are Roman, French. Right, no, those are maximum words. Greek might be, but again, they kept on. The English went for this change from those to it, to the different the current English that we are speaking from these languages changed. So these words have a origin, and once you know these root words, it becomes easy for you to remember vocabulary. Let me tell you how it makes it easy. Now let's take a word like THE or THEO. Wherever we have this word THE or THEO, it means God. THE or THEO means God. Now I don't need to remember if it is of Greek origin or of it is of the Roman origin or of French origin. Ye mera zarurat ka nahi hai, because it is unnecessarily an information overload. I don't need it. What? Because I'm not going to do any research on etymology. My job is that my objective is that I should be able to remember the word easily without straining my memory and all. So now if THE or THEO means God, then any word which has got this, like say theocracy, theosophical, theology, atheist, like this, all these words that you hear, there you have this word, root word THE or THEO means God. Like say theocracy, the first word that I told you is theocracy. Theo is God, cracy means rule. Cracy is rule, because democracy, autocracy, plutocracy, all those you have, aristocracy. So cracy is rule. So theocracy means a form of government ruled by the religious heads. Say for example, the head of the Vatican City, which is the smallest country in the world. Vatican City, the head is Pope, the Pope, the Christian religious head. So that is a theocratic society. There was this Iran, the head of Iran, religious head of Iran was Ayatollah Khomeini. So he was, Iran was a theocratic society. So like this, all those countries where the religious head is the head of the state, that is known as a theocratic society. Then you have theosophical, a society which is formed, or a trust which is formed in the name of God. Theo is God. So a trust or a society formed in the name of God is theosophical. Then a theology. Logy is study. The study of God. Theo is God. Logy is study. So theology, study of God, is theology. Theist, one who believes in God, is theist. Atheist, one who does not believe in God. See, so by default, if you remember one root word, you will be able to remember by default something around 7, 8 to 10 words. You can make an intelligent guess. Guys, these entrances expect a candidate to be intelligent. They are not looking at your mugging up skills. They are looking at how analytical your brain is, how good is your intelligence. Can you use your intelligence to answer questions, not mug it up? So that is why they give you the synonyms and all as part of the vocabulary test and all. So that is Theo. I just gave you one example. Then let me give you another example. Say Ben, Benny, or Bon, B-E-N, or B-E-N-E, or B-O-N. Wherever you have these three words as a prefix. Prefix means word ke pehle, saamne mein use kiya gaya, lagaya gaya usko. So that means good. Yeah, good. Now look at the word benefit, good. Benefactor, benevolent, benison, benediction, benign, bon voyage, bona fide, bon vivere, then bonfire. Look at these words. All these words you can easily guess by knowing a root word that is good. Right? So, say a few words from there. Let me tell you, what is this benediction? Benny is good. Dict, D-I-C-T. Benediction spelling is B-E-N-E-D-I-C-T-I-O-N. Benediction. So dict, D-I-C-T, means words. Benny means good. Good words means boon or blessing. Boon or blessing is benediction. Right? So the good word is blessings or boon. Say bona fide. Let's take the word bona fide. Bon is good. Fide means faith. Fide is the root word for faith. Means fidelity, infidelity, all the words come from there. So fide means faith. So when we say bona fide, means having good faith, a student of good faith or trust, that is bona fide. Bonfire. Bonfire, you know, where they burn a fire in between. No, beech mein lakdi rakh ke aag lagate hain aur uske charon taraf sab baith ke gana gaate hain ya to kuch hansi mazak karte hain. So wo ek acha fire, good fire, because it gives you warmth. It gives you warmth. Normally cold countries, of course, they do it. So it gives you warmth. So that is why it is a good fire. So it is bonfire. Right? Say benign. When the doctor tells to a patient that you don't have to worry, the tumor is benign. The tumor is benign means the tumor is good, means harmless. Good means a tumor obviously cannot be good, but it is harmless. So that is a root word. Again, let us take another root word. Say som, S-O-M-N. Som means sleep. Som, S-O-M-N. Som means sleep. Insomnia is a very common word with which you can associate the root word. Yes, there's a point that I would like to make. Always try to connect a root word with the simplest word that you know. Because with each root word, you know a very, very simple word. Because till now, whatever words I told you, T-H-E with that you know a very common word like atheist, one who does not believe in God, is a very common word. Say for the word Ben, Benny, or Bon, you know Bon Voyage, you know Benefit, you know Benevolent, you know Benefactor. So these are all common words which are with the word Ben or Benny. Right? Similarly, with the root word Som, S-O-M-N, which means sleep. Som means sleep. So with you can connect that to with the simplest word that you know, that is insomnia. Lack of sleep is insomnia. So if you connect these root words with the simplest word that you know, you don't again have to. Because again, if you are trying to mug up root words, सो फायदा क्या हुआ, दैट्स वॉट माई ऑब्जेक्टिव इज, दैट मुझे नो आई डोंट हैव टू मग अप, मुझे कुछ कोई भी वर्ड को रट्टा लगाना ना पड़े, मैं उसको नो एनालिटिकली उसको याद रख सकूं, या आई कैन यूज माई इंटेलिजेंस टू रिमेंबर, बट आई विल नॉट यूज दिस मग इट अप, राइट. सो सोम, सोम मन इज स्लीप. नाउ विद दैट वर्ड सोम कम्स द वर्ड इनसोमिया, द फर्स्ट वर्ड विच यू नो, देन सोमनम्बुलिस्ट, सोमनीलोक्वेंट, then all these kind of, all these words from where, wherever S-O-M-N is used in the, for, as a prefix, that it is in insomnia, it is also used as a in the middle. So these words, when they are used, it means it has something to do with sleep. Now in the exam, suppose the word comes as somnambulist, I don't know the meaning. For example, I do not know the meaning of somnambulist, but what I can do, I can look at the word, I can see the word, then I know that som is there, and I know that som is to something to do with sleep. Let me look at the four options. There will be one option. Yes, only one option. That's again a question which students ask me. Sir, agar char option hua sleep se, nahi aisa hota. Kyunki jo examiner hai, jaise as I said, no, unko test karna hota tumhara intelligence. Unko no, tum kitna no, ya ratta laga ke yaad rakh sakte ho, unko wo nahi test karna hai. Unko test karna hai ki tum intelligent ho ki nahi. So you know som is sleep. To charo option mein se ek option hoga jo ki स्लीप से रिलेटेड होगा, या उसमें स्लीप वर्ड लिखा होगा. सो यू कैन इजिली टिक, क्योंकि इस वर्ड में सोमनम्बुलिस्ट है और सोम माने स्लीप, सो ऑप्शन में डेफिनेटली जो आंसर होगा उसमें स्लीप होना चाहिए, राइट. सो सोमनम्बुलिस्ट क्या है, सोम इज स्लीप, एम्बल AMBUL, एम्बल, उस वर्ड AMBUL एम्बल से बना है द वर्ड एम्बुलेंस, एम्बुलेंस वर्ड उसी वर्ड से बना है एम्बल से. एम्बुलेंस क्या करता है, एक पेशेंट को मूव करवाता है हॉस्पिटल, घर से हॉस्पिटल, या तो हॉस्पिटल से घर पे. सो वो मूव करवाता है एक पेशेंट को. सो एम्बल मीन्स टू वॉक और मूव. ओके, सो सोमनम्बुलिस्ट, सो एम्बल इज टू वॉक और मूव, एंड सो सोमनम्बुलिस्ट इज, सोम इज स्लीप, एम्बल इज वॉक. सो वन हु वॉक्स इन स्लीप इज अ सोमनम्बुलिस्ट. सो नींद में चलने की बीमारी, दैट इज सोमनम्बुलिस्ट, बिकॉज सोम मीन्स स्लीप, नींद, एंड एम्बल मीन्स वॉक या चलना. सो सोमनम्बुलिस्ट इज नींद में चलने की बीमारी, दैट इज सोमनम्बुलिस्ट. सोमनीलोक्वेंट, सो सोम मीन्स स्लीप, वी नाउ नो, नाउ वी नो दैट सोम का अर्थ है स्लीप, एंड लोक्यू, लोक्यू मीन्स स्पीक, लोक्यू इज स्पीक. इन द स्कूल यू हैड दिस इलोक्यूशन कॉम्पिटिशन where you were given a topic on which you spoke, you also say that he is very eloquent, right, one who speaks well. So locu is to speak. So when we say somniloquent, so som is sleep, locu means speak, so one who speaks in sleep is somniloquent, got it. So that is a, there is another root word which I definitely would like to mention along with this, is one is som, and the other root word is soporo, S-O-P-O-R-O. Soporo means also sleep. So soporific, soporific means which induces sleep, means jo jis jo no jisko dekhne se ya to jiske karan neend aata hai, jiske karan neend aata hai, so that is soporific, right. That is also, soporo is also a Roman word for sleep. Now, then you have, say, suppose we take another root word, say, we have,